Good morning, good afternoon, good evening viewers. I hope you're all doing good. So in this video, I'll show you certain trades and trends in Bank Nifty from the beginning of this year, which is Jan 2020, till the last week of the trade that has elapsed in July, which is July 18th. And one trading strategy that will most likely yield really good results in our trade. So we all know that, the Bank Nifty, the trade for Bank Nifty, it starts from Friday and then it expires on Thursday of every week. So for this particular trade or this trade idea that I'm going to discuss, we will consider the trade for Bank Nifty that starts on Monday and that goes on till end of day Thursday. And we will not consider the trade that happens on Friday because we want to just discount the decay that kicks in on the premium over the weekend. Okay, so let's take a look at the sheet and then let me try and explain you what this is. So as you see, this is the date of the trade of the Bank Nifty. So the price is basically the closing over the previous day. Open, high, low, volume and change percentage are self-explanatory for the day. The price at which Bank Nifty opened, the high that it hit, the low that it hit, what was the volume that was traded in Bank Nifty, and what was the percentage change during the day. Now, for a moment, let's not worry about these things. This is just what is the difference between the high and low on that day. What was the percentage change between the same day over day, right? I mean, from the previous day to this day. And how much high did it go from its opening and how much low did it hit from the opening, okay? These two columns, weekly open to high and weekly open to low, are very important to us. And let me explain to you what this means. Weekly open to high indicates from the time of opening on Monday, what was the highest, that Bank Nifty hit. So let us assume that Bank Nifty opened on July 13th at 22,627. Okay. As we see here, the maximum that it has hit is 21,000, the high was 22,643 only. So basically, it has not moved a lot in the positive direction in the last week that has elapsed in Bank Nifty, right? Between Monday to Thursday. And if you see here, weekly open to low, this indicates at what price the Bank Nifty opened and what was the lowest point it hit. So if you see, the Bank Nifty opened at 22,627, but the lowest that it went was to 21,033. So it recorded a most negative direction of 1,594 points. So what does this mean, right? So like this, what I have done is between Monday to Friday, you see these color codings. I have gone ahead and I have traced this starting from Jan 2020, like I said. So from Jan 2020, if we see here, we see four trades or three trades, depending on how many days it traded between those days. And we notice similar things, right? So let us try and understand, what are the specific things that I wanted to show you. Every week, starting from January till July, we see that, Bank Nifty has made a decent move of 800 to 1000 plus points on one side or the other, which means that Bank Nifty either went up by 1000 points or it dropped by 1000 points, in these 4 days of trade between Monday and Thursday. Like you see here, Bank Nifty fell by 1000 points. Here it was flat, right? I mean, in this week it did not move much. Here it fell by 1065. Here again, it was just 600 points losing. If you see here, it was 1065 gain, okay? And then if we see here, again, it was flat. So these are the three or four weeks where Bank Nifty was range bound. Here, if you see, it is 600, 700, 1500, 3500, 5300, 2100 loss and almost 2100 gains, okay? So likewise, every week, right? I mean, you see that Bank Nifty has either gone up or it has come down by authoritative 1000 points in one direction or the other. Now, Now that we have established, you know, that the Bank Nifty is fluctuating 1,000 points in one direction or the other, it could be positive or negative, how do I trade this? Okay. So there are certain rules of trade that I want to, you know, discuss. The first one is we have to enter the trade on Monday, whatever the trade that I will probably tell you now. Enter the trade on Monday morning between 10:30 and 11:30 a.m. Okay. Don't enter before this because there is a lot of fluctuation that happens during this time between 9:15 to 10:30. So let it settle for that time and then maybe you can enter at around 10:15, 10:30 till 11:30 a.m. So once you enter you know, the trade at this time, the holding time for these trades is till end of day Thursday or till the targets are hit. So when you buy, you are supposed to purchase both call and put, which is 400 point out of the money from the current spot at the price at the time at which you are buying. Okay, let's assume that on you know, on Monday morning when you want to buy the spot. Okay, let me write it down. The spot is at 22,200. I'm just giving an example. So the put that you should be buying should be for 21,800, and the call that you should be buying should be for 22,600. Okay. And whatever is the premium that you get for this P1 and P2, okay? So the combined value of these premium generally at that time ranges between 300 and 400 rupees, okay? So that is what you should be looking at. So based on the current lot size, which is 20, your premium should range between 6,000 to 8,000 rupees for one lot of both, a combined one lot of call and put, okay? Once you have this, the next thing is to ensure that you hold on to this till you see a 20% gains. And generally, you see this 20% gains. You know, let's say that if the put was priced at, you know, 150 and the call is priced at 150, if it goes in one direction or the other, generally this may fall to 100. You know, and this may fall. This may go up to whatever. I mean, let's say. 260. Okay. So the combined price of this, which was at 300, now if you see the combined price of this will be at 260, assuming that the market inches towards call. Okay. Or the other way around, if it happens, then put will go up and call will fall. But over a period of time, you will definitely see this traction and this direction coming in, where initially, assuming that the spot is moving towards call, put will lose, you know, quickly than call gaining. But once it reaches closer to the call, you will see that, you know, this moving to 260 quickly, and this you know, stopping in its fall or being a little bit more range bound in its fall from that day, because you still have 3 or 4 days more for expiry. Okay. So having said that, how do you make the trade, right? I mean, you either get out of this trade at a 15-20% gains, or the second trade to be made is, since we understand that you know, the markets are fluctuating anywhere from 600 to 1,000 points or 800 to 1,000 plus point on either direction, even if you stay the course till end of day Thursday, you are pretty sure that, you know, the premium for either call or put, when it is in the money by almost 500-600 points, you can be certain that the premium for it will be closer to 400 plus rupees or 500 plus rupees, which is a lot higher than the combined premium of this. So your profits will be a lot better than this. Okay. That is the second trade. The first trade, like I said, you exit for 20%. The second trade, you know, assuming that this goes to, you know, 10, and if this goes up by 1,000 point, which is basically 23,600, then your 23,200, then your this thing becomes 600 rupees, and probably you'll see it at 550 rupees or whatever. Okay, this is my trade one. This is my trade two. And trade three is, you know, you purchase at least two or three lots of Bank Nifty. Exit one lot at one or two lots at the first trade, which is by booking 20% or 25% of your profits, and keep one lot, you know, for the rest of the trade. Okay, which basically means that you carry over the trades till you see complete, you know, profits in one trade of either call or put. Okay. So we have been testing this and trading in this for quite some time now, and it is showing good results. So yeah, I mean, there is no guarantee in this trade, but then yes, I obviously believe that this is one of the safest bets, assuming that, you know, market keeps moving wildly like the way it has been over the last 20 plus weeks. All right. So if we really see, friends, I mean, Bank Nifty has fluctuated a lot in the last 27 weeks, right? There are just 3 weeks where Bank Nifty did not fluctuate more than 600 points. There are 24 weeks in which Bank Nifty has fluctuated more than 800 points in one direction in the same week. So essentially, it means that there are very bright chances of you hitting this 25% or a decent 50 to 100% gains in the same week if you hold on to this trade with good discipline. All right. Thank you, friends. I think that is it for the day. So have a good day and a good trading session. Thank you. Bye-bye.